Asteroids are rocky objects that orbit the sun, but are too small to be classified as planets. They're also referred to as planetoids or small planets. Millions of asteroids range from hundreds of kilometers to a few feet. The combined mass of all asteroids is less than that of Earth's moon. Asteroids, regardless of size, can be dangerous. Many have already collided with Earth, and more will do so in the future. That is one of the reasons scientists are interested in asteroids and want to understand more about their numbers, orbits, and physical features. If an asteroid is heading our way, we want to know because the last time an asteroid hit the planet, no one saw the catastrophe coming, and everything changed. Dinosaurs followed one another and ate lush greens as they had done for almost 170 million years. Then everything changed in an instant. A 6-mile vast chunk of extraterrestrial rock blasted against what would become known as Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula. The shock was like a gunshot on a grand scale. The world would never be the same after that. Experts are digging through the rock record to piece together a nightmare vision of one of the darkest days in our planet's history. Some of the damage is obvious. The impact crater is nearly 110 miles in diameter, a gigantic scar that is half buried by the Gulf of Mexico. The devil lies in the geological specifics at various locations throughout the planet, such as signs of a giant tsunami off the Gulf Coast. The impact was so powerful and displaced so much water that within 10 hours, an enormous wave tore its way up the coast. What settled out is a geologic mess. Ocean sand on what would have been dry land and fossils of land plants in areas that should have been the ocean in a mixed-up slurry of ancient sediment. In the part of the world where the tsunami struck, these layers mark a violent boundary between the last day of the Cretaceous and first of the following period of Paleocene. The consequences were not limited to the area of impact. The bomb was powerful enough to induce geologic disturbances, including earthquakes and landslides as far as Argentina, resulting in their own tsunamis. However, as perilous as the waves were, to live in the Western Hemisphere, the heat was far more. Earth was transformed into a burning world. Most dinosaurs and many other terrestrial species could not have escaped because they were not underground or underwater. Animals trapped in the open may have been killed immediately from many hours of severe heat, while the continuous blow ignited dried-out vegetation in some spots, sparking wildfires. While scientists continue to piece together what happened back then, a new threat is emerging that might change everything. On April 13, 2029, a potentially hazardous asteroid, PHA named Apophis, will pass inside the orbit of our geosynchronous satellites. That is about 23,000 kilometers from the Earth's surface, and that's pretty close. Apophis is massive. It was discovered in 2005 and is estimated to measure roughly 340 meters in diameter. That's roughly the height of the Empire State Building in Manhattan, New York. The asteroid was titled Apophis in 2005 after the Greek term for an old Egyptian depiction of evil, a serpent that resides in darkness and frequently tries to swallow the sun god Ra as he makes his nightly transit through the sky. An asteroid the size of Apophis passing so near to Earth is considered a once-in-a-thousand-year event. Apophis will not strike our planet on April 13, 2029, but scientists believe that the close flyby will alter its trajectory, and disastrously. It's possible that Earth's swing-by could put it on an Earth-resonant impact trajectory that comes in 2060 or 2068. Thanks to the tremendous size of Apophis, its close passage will be so dazzling that around 2 billion people can see it with their own eyes. The asteroid will first be visible in the southern hemisphere as a bright star blazing across the sky from east to west, passing over Australia, then the Indian Ocean, and finally crossing the equator over Africa. From visual observations taken in 2004, researchers calculated that there was around a 2.7% chance that the PHA would hit Earth in 2029. These probabilities were refined with radar observations the following year. These estimates may seem low, but were still extreme enough to give Apophis the highest value on two systems used by astronomers to calculate how dangerous an asteroid is to our planet. The Torino scale created by Binzel, who was a member of the team that was studying the structure of the asteroid, and the Palermo Technical Impact Hazard Scale. By 2006, the likelihood of Apophis colliding with Earth in 2029 was almost nil, but future collisions, particularly in 2026, could not be eliminated lightly. The track of Apophis after its flyby in 2029 will be determined by how Earth's gravity affects the asteroid's orbit According to David Ferrocchio, an astronomer at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, JPL, who is investigating the asteroid's trajectory. If Apophis went through precise gravitational keyholes, the gravity of the Earth would adjust its orbit just enough, or should I say the wrong amount, to place it on a crash course in a later year, Ferrocchio explained. Astronomers could not track Apophis from 2015 to 2019 because it was too close to the Sun and so hidden by its light output. Hence, further progress in ruling out a 2068 collision was not made. Thus, the asteroid seemed almost stubbornly determined to live up to its apocalyptic name. While evidence acquired over the last 2 years shows that Apophis will not pose a threat to Earth for another 100 years, what if it does? Scientists have investigated models of an Apophis-scale impact with Earth and concluded that the outcome of an Apophis-scale impact with Earth is highly unpredictable. If Apophis struck Earth at 45,000 miles per hour, the typical speed of asteroid impacts, the energy release would be around 10 billion joules, which is 1 followed by 19 zeros. This is equivalent to the explosive yield of the world's nuclear arsenal. Almost 100,000 times more energy than the Chelyabinsk meteor, and 1,000,000 times more energy than the Hiroshima bombs. The worst-case scenario for an impact of this magnitude would be if it occurred near a significant population center or along a heavily populated coastline. If this happens, various secondary effects such as strong earth shaking, intense heat radiation, and air shock waves would have disastrous implications. With 8 years of planning still remaining before its next visit, the sky is the limit for Apophis's investigation. Apophis's close approach may provide more than just cosmic visual entertainment. Scientists have eagerly proposed possible missions to rendezvous with the object on or around its passage in 2029. Now at least one visitor from our planet has been confirmed. NASA's OSIRIS-REx spacecraft initially launched in 2016 on a mission to collect samples from another asteroid, Bennu, and bring them back to Earth. OSIRIS-REx is currently on its way home from its successful encounter with Bennu and is scheduled to drop off its invaluable samples in September 2023. However, spacecraft will continue to orbit the Earth, prompting NASA to accept a $200 million mission extension. OSIRIS-REx will now meet Apophis, transforming into OSIRIS-APEX, OSIRIS-Apophis Explorer. OSIRIS-APEX will approach Apophis a few months after its close encounter with Earth, completing preliminary reconnaissance before entering orbit around the asteroid in August 2029. Mission scientists will map the surface for any noteworthy changes caused by Apophis's brief descent into our planet's gravitational hold. OSIRIS-APEX is not the only mission to visit Apophis, nor is it the only one focused on planetary defense. For now, Apophis poses no immediate threat to Earth. But in 2029, for a brief moment, it will fire a warning shot as it breezes through our skies, followed briefly by at least one inquisitive observer. We'll have to wait and see what the future years bring. We hope Apophis changes its trajectory and passes by the Earth. What do you guys think? Will Apophis pass without damaging our planet, or is the apocalypse coming? Do share your thoughts in the comments section. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, give this video a big thumbs up, and hit the bell icon to stay updated about our future uploads.